one evening, as the sun went down and the jungle fires were burning, down the track came a whole little hiking. And he said, "Boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed to a land that's far away, beside the crystal fountains. Now come with me, we'll go and see the Big Rock Candy Mountains."
And the Big Rock Candy Mountain is a land that's fair and dry, where the hemlocks grow on bushes and you sleep out every night, where the boxcars all are empty and the sun shines every day on the birds and the bees and the sycamore trees. The lemonade springs where the bluebird sings in the Big Rock Candy Mountain.
In the Big Rock Candy Mountain, all the cocks have wooden legs, and the bulldogs all have rubber teeth, and the hens lay soft-boiled eggs. The farmer's trees are full of fruit, and the barns are full of hay. Oh, we're bound to go where there ain't no snow, where the rain don't fall, the wind don't blow, in the Big Rock Candy Mountain.
In the Big Rock Candy Mountain, all the chairs are made of tin, and you can walk right out again as soon as you are in. There ain't no short-handled shovels, no axes, saws, or picks. I'm going to stay with sleep all day, beneath the turf and the venting work in the Big Rock Candy Mountain. See you all this coming fall in the Big Rock Candy Mountains.
Mother Hicks is a witch, people say, and she lives all alone at the top of Dug Hill, and she works her magic on the town below.
When cracks is seen in the dry creek bed,
when the corn burns up,
when a calf's born dead,
Mother Hicks is a witch, people say.
When a child falls sick, there ain't no cause and there ain't no cure,
and everybody knows that it's wish for sure,
Mother Hicks is a witch, people say.
This time spring, 1935, a year of fear in the Great Depression, this place is where W-A-R-E, the Mississippi River's right over there. This place is southern Illinois, but we call it Egypt.
My name is Tuck. I cannot speak, I cannot hear. I use my hands, and the words appear. I hang these words in the air for you to tell a story that I know is true, because I heard every word with my eyes. It's deep and early, just before dawn.
A dare is a dare and done. Dare and double dare. To sneak out over the fence at the power station and fetch the quarter that Ricky threw there, up and over the fence and down again into the cool wet grass below. But then I heard it, that stinging, singing sound, racing through them wires and round them coils and cables, like the electricity wanted to be out like lightning bolts. It's true fact that I do dares of mortal danger, things that no one else in town would dare to do or dare to tell they'd done them. A dare is a dare and done.
Girl, hey, you hear, girl?
Hoo, hoo.
Dang it, girl, come out! If my mom finds I'm not dead!
Boo!
Dang it, girl, you made me jump to glory!
You should have guessed, Ricky, them hoot owls live in trees.
It's 5 o'clock in the morning, and I don't exactly feel like guessing.
But there is a dare and done.
My quarter.
His quarter. Nope. My quarter.
I was sure she'd get electrocuted doing that dare.
Yeah.
A dare and dare unless there's danger. You got the money?
I don't know why we have to do this so early. Why can't we just wait till...
Because I need the money now.
Then hand him over.
Ricky, you know how you always wanted a pet, but your mom wouldn't let you get a dog because it'd slobber up the house?
Yeah.
Well, I decided to sell you my frogs.
Your frogs?
Frogs. I raised them since they were squiggles. They're good hoppers and they all got names.
Names?
Names. I figure frogs with names is worth more than regular.
Deal's a deal. You promised to sell me your Tom Mix Wrangler badge.
Yeah.
Your book garage pocket watch.
Yeah.
And your Orphan Annie Secret Society code book.
Yeah. I did a million dares to get all that stuff.
And all the seals he collected from the Ovaltine jars.
I had to go through all the garbage in the whole city dump to get those.
Deal's a deal. I'm also with the Jack Armstrong whistle ring.
But Jackie gave me that whistle. She sent for it with Wheaties box tops.
No whistle, no deal.
But it's the only thing that ever came through the mail just for me.
Guess you don't want my money.
I need your money, Ricky. I need it bad.
Not bad enough.
Fine. You can have the whistle. Shoot fire. You can have anything you want.
except for my quilt piece.
Who won that dirty old thing?
That shows how much you know. This here's fine embroidery on these here initials, ISH. Fine embroidery by somebody's own hand.
Let's go see those frogs. Maybe I'll buy them a penny apiece.
A penny? They's worth at least a nickel.
I can catch them myself.
With names? Can you catch them with names and trade?
A baby girl found in town about 13 years ago. People took her in and raised her here and there and all around. And so she goes in and out of people's houses like so many times before. She rests a while inside a family until they can't keep her anymore. And then she goes here.
Girl! Come here, girl! Come on, get out before it's a storm.
I got it, Jackie, I got it!
Girl, I told you, I got me in Cairo by this afternoon, and I can't go until I see you safely off to the war.
Sit down, Jackie.
Alan and Becca packed up all your things. All the crap.
Sit down.
No, girl. This one time you ain't gonna get me buffaloed. I got to get going.
No, you don't.
Girl.
I caught it for you, Jackie. I got the money.
What?
I've been collecting bottles at a penny apiece. I run groceries for Mr. Udy. I pulled weeds for Miss Knox, and I sold some stuff. I got $6.43.
Girl, that's real fine. And Alan and me were grateful. But we're gonna need a bit more for the mortgage.
How much?
$256.
That's a lot of frogs.
Huh?
I can earn it. I can get me a real job.
Girl, it's over. They took the farm and they sell it for back payments. Can't say where I can't work.
Well, Bob Ricks, he digs ditches on the county road. Ricky told me.
Now that is a WPA job. WPA stands for We Piddle Around. I wouldn't take a handout from them crooks in Washington if my life depended on it. Their jobs in Cairo. Real jobs.
Take me with you.
Girl, I can't.
I could get me a real job in Cairo. I could give you and Ella all the money.
Girl, you know I love to take you. Heck, I like you better than some of my own kids. But you're not a kid, and I cannot take responsibility for none of them soul right now.
I won't take up much room, and I won't eat hardly nothing.
Girl, neither God nor nature ever sent me anything I couldn't handle. Last year, when the flood came, I built 12 sandbags. And when we had that tornado, I knew how to get everyone into that storm shelter to wait it out. But even the wars get enemies with bullets. There's something happening in this country right now, like a terrible silent storm. I can't see it, and I can't hear it, and I don't know how to fight it, and it scares me.
I got used to your family, Jackie.
Hush now.
I never got used to anything before.
Now, chewing back will be the first habit you'll break. Mama Ward have a heart attack first time she see you spit.
I ain't going to live with no grave digger.
Mortician.
He digs graves, don't he?
At least Josiah Ward never be out of work.
I won't go to the wards. He smells like chemicals, and she's got a face like somebody's foot.
Now Alma Ward is a very nice lady. And besides, they can afford to give you a home.
I won't go.
They're the only ones in town who'll take you. You're just about used up everybody else.
I'll run away. I'll hitch me a ride to Cairo and I'll find my people.
Girl, I told you we can't take you.
I mean my real people.
Oh, girl, put that title dream of yours and put it away. Your people is long gone and never were.
That's all you know, Jackie. Maybe they're rich. Maybe they got a truck bigger than yours. Maybe they got a family better than yours. Maybe they got jobs and lots of money.
Now, if they're so rich, how come they never found you?
Because I'm hard to find.
Well, dang it, girl, you get back here.
There's a certain kind of spell in the air everywhere.
You can tell very well that it's fear. Things begin to disappear.
Gone is the money in the bank.
Gone are the jobs.
Gone are the homes.
And the families and their plans.
But they seem so safe.
But they seem so sure.
All of a sudden, everybody's poor.
Where did it go?
Who took it all away?
Mother Hicks is a witch, people say.
Ricky Rick, you get back here and you eat your own meal. You'll get it for supper, see you don't. You too, Ray Ray. Tuck. Oh, Tuck. I've got something for you. Now you wait right here. I don't know why I always do that. I know perfectly well that boy is deaf as a fire plug, but I always call out.
Ricky Briggs, you just about gave my arm off.
Sorry, I'm not.
You seen the girl? My mom's looking everywhere for her.
I thought you was leaving today.
That's why I'm looking. She's got the keys.
to dare me to pee on an electric fan while it was running. Now you gotta go up behind Tuck and touch him without him seeing you.
That ain't nothing.
You gotta use your whole hand and not just one finger.
You do it.
Go on, it's your dare.
I don't know. I ain't got time and my mom's really mad and...
You got time for this.
Okay, okay.
What's the matter?
I'm going.
Then go.
Fritz, you dumb fool. If you hit him, he'll probably kill you.
I was just giving you some cover.
Yeah, sure.
The dare was to touch him, not to hurt
him. Girl.
Get off him.
Girl.
It's a catch-up. I got him. Now wouldn't you know I found you, Fat?
I found him for you, Ma. I found the keys.
They was throwing rocks, trying to hit it.
No, I wasn't. It was Ricky. He's the one with...
Shut up, Howie.
I found him for you, Ma.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Shut up, Howie.
Now, girl. Now, who found these keys for me?
I did.
You didn't?
Yes, I did.
Shut up, Howie. Now, girl, you're coming with me to the wards and you are coming now.
We are going to Cairo and you can't go. We are going to Cairo and you can't go. We are going to Cairo.
Shut up, Howie! You run home and tell your brothers and sisters I'll be there in 5 minutes.
Yes, ma'am.
And wound up all the kids. I ain't waiting on anybody, you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Get off.
Well, Jackie Hammond, I thought you and all those kids were going to Cairo.
We're trying, Izzy.
I'm trying. Well, good luck to you.
They're gonna do a little good luck.
I expect you all.
Shoot fire, Jackie. It weren't my fault.
This here's clothes. Old clothes. Now, I swear you can see the daylight through the knees of these here jeans, but I'm sure you'll find use for them. They say he reads lips, but I'm not so sure.
Come on. I have Princess to go.
Handed down people and handed down clothes pass from one to another when the wear starts to show. They give to feel good and then go on their way. They don't know how it feels to be given away.
My only sunshine, you make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. But when I woke, dear, I was mistaken. So I hung my head and I cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
These barrels and bags here, move them over there, here to there, understand? Comprende? Got it?
Excuse me, is this place called where?
This place is called Clovis Piuti's General Mercantile, the town's where. That's the mail truck.
I beg your pardon. My name's Wilson Walker. I'm from the University of Carbondale. I'm collecting research on sayings and stories and tellings, that kind of thing, for a book about this region. My name is Tuck. I am deaf and mute. Oh my goodness, I'm so sorry! Please do not shout. If you speak slowly, I can read your lips.
Leave him alone. He's working.
I didn't realize.
What do you want?
Just information.
Information's free.
My name's Wilson Walker. I'm with the Federal Rights Project.
From the government?
Sort of.
I ain't got nothing to say.
Mr. Udy, Mr. Udy! Afternoon mail here yet?
Still in the bag.
Anything for me?
Do you think I got x-ray eyes?
I'm expecting a very important letter from Jackie Hammond. You see, she promised to send for me just as soon as she got to Cairo.
You seen the last of that dirt farmer and her family. Now the wards is nice people and you've got a good home.
It ain't my home.
Well, you belong there anyway.
I can't.
Why not?
They sent me for groceries. Here's the list from the Stiff House.
Girl.
And one more thing that should be on that list. A plug of Red Man.
Girl, I can't sell you chewing tobacco. I'll go check the mail.
Hi.
Hi.
You're new around here.
I'm just passing through.
Do you chew?
Huh?
I don't suppose you chew, do you?
Oh yeah, sure. Have a stick of Wrigley's.
Thanks. What's your name?
Wilson Walker.
Two last names? That's dumb.
Oh yeah? What's yours?
Girl.
I can see that. What's your name?
It's Washington.
Huh?
It's a Cherokee name. You know, like these here initials on this Cherokee Indian blanket? I'm practically three quarters Cherokee.
So how'd you get over here to Illinois then, Cherokee?
In a trunk.
A trunk?
My people was vaudeville, and they was always having babies and trunks and...
I thought you said you were Cherokee Indian.
They was Cherokee vaudeville.
So, where is everyone today? Or is this town usually this dead?
They're all at the funeral. Zolly Phelps got himself witched.
Witched?
That's what everybody says.
Looks like I came to the right place.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. I hunt witches.
Oh, yeah?
Figure I put in on 15, maybe 20 witches in Carthage and Karnak.
Well, what are you to hunt them with? Cross, silver bullet, holy water, Bible?
I trap them here in these pages and hold them tight so people can read about it forever.
You talk like a loon.
I'm with the WPA.
The WPA? I wouldn't take a handout from those crooks in Washington if my life depended on it.
Handout? It's the job.
Hey, girl.
She sent for me. I knew she would.
This letter is for Hosiah. This package from Chicago is for Alma. You best take it home along with you.
I told you, it ain't my home.
Afternoon, Mr. Needy. Is my mom here yet? She says she'll meet me here after the funeral.
She'll be along. Expect to get into the amens and hallelujahs. Any hail over to your place?
Yes, sir. Hail is big as knuckle bones.
Queer time of year for hail.
Hail in June is the devil's moon.
That's what my mom says.
I'll go check on your order, girl.
Hey, girl. Want to see a neat ring I got here?
Not especially. Hey, Ricky. How about if I come to live with you at your place for a while?
Sure.
You give me back my quarter?
Yeah.
She can sleep with the baby. She don't do nothing but cry and make bad smells.
I don't mind.
You got a cold, boy?
I was just seeing if he smelled like the dead yet.
Get out of here.
Well, you've been staying over to the grave diggers.
I'm gonna bust you one if you don't.
Do I?
Does she?
Not so I can tell. Of course. I never smelled dead.
Neither have I.
Neither have I.
They make you sleep in a coffin.
Shut up, Ricky.
You ever seen any bodies?
I'm warning you.
All right, girl.
Ricky Ricks, you've been stealing those licorice whips again. You know I always end up paying for them later.
I like snitching them better.
Yep.
Boys.
Oh, hey, Miss Ricks. I'm gonna come to live with you at your house for a while. Ricky and Ray Ray said it was okay.
But you're staying over with Almond Hosiah Ward.
You don't want me, huh?
We can't afford you. Not now. Sorry.
If feeling any better today, Izzy?
Oh, not hardly. I feel like I'm something set for that couldn't come. If I didn't know any better, I'd have sworn I'd been hexed.
How was the funeral?
Poor old Zolly. He sure did look, oh, I don't know, dead. It was witch work, Clovis. Witch work.
You think?
I know. Last time she came to town, Zolly cursed her for making his house go dry. From that day on, he was a dead man.
Zolly Phelps was a drunk.
You watch your mouth, girl. He was my cousin.
Well, Jackie Hammond always said that witches was bunk.
Well, Jackie Hammond didn't know everything, young lady. There's not the same person in this town who can make light of witches. Not in witch weather.
Witch weather?
When it's cold like this, long past time for summer. When the thunder clouds roll in and the hail comes like frozen pieces of lightning, then Mother Hicks, up to her old tricks.
Did you say Mother Hicks?
What if I did?
My name is Wilson Walker. I'm with the Federal Writers Project.
Federal Writers Project? I've heard of that. I heard Miss Roosevelt talking about it on the radio.
Yes, ma'am. I'm with the folklore division. My subject is witchcraft.
Witchcraft, you say?
Yeah. I was on my way to Jonesboro, but I thought I'd stop by and find out about this Mother Hicks.
Well, you better look up on Doug Hill. You won't find her down here in town.
People say she's a witch.
Mother Hicks is a witch, all right. And she lives all alone at the top of Doug Hill. And most every night, at midnight, she goes to the graveyard and casts spells with devil dolls and tiny little clothes and tiny little shoes.
She used to be a midwife.
Until she stopped birthing babies and started witching them.
The babies got sick.
Babies died.
People say she just had a child herself once.
A little girl, but she gave that child to the devil.
Oh. Now, don't these little bitches have just the biggest ears?
Cut it out, Mom.
What about you, Two Names? Do you believe in witches?
I've collected 5 whole notebooks full of stories.
Stories are lies.
The people who told them it's true. I believe every voice in these here notebooks.
You see that poor, unfortunate boy over there?
Yeah.
Mother Hicks witched him when she came to nurse him through the fever.
First, she nursed him, then she witched him. When he cried that fever cry, she touched his throat and caught that cry. Then she looked at him with an evil eye and sucked all his sounds up into silence. Mother Hicks, she's a witch all right.
Mother Hicks is a witch.
You know, people say that. What's going on?
Shut up, you fool.
It's her, isn't it? I want to talk to her.
Then you go up on Doug Hill all by yourself. Don't you see? She's only down here because of the funeral. She must have smelled it all the way up Witch Mountain.
Ah! You just about made me jump to glory.
Your order's ready, girl. You take the sack home along with you. I'll send Tug along the heavier things. Now you go straight home.
How do I get to Doug Hill?
Just up the Jonesboro Road.
Good. That's the way I'm headed.
Well, you won't find her. Not unless she won't be found. Come on, Borky. Let's go. Good luck, Mr. Wilson.
Walker.
Wilson, Walker, whatever. Goodbye.
Thank you. You've been most helpful.
Wait.
What?
Good luck, Two Names.
So long, Cherokee.
Hey, girl. I know the dare of dares. The dare of dares.
What?
Go up to the graveyard late tonight and touch Mother Hicks if she comes.
Shut up, Ricky.
Dare and double dare?
Dare and double dare.
In the highways, in the hedges, in the highways, in the
she is told. Instead, she does a dare or two. Like going down to that railroad track when the Rock Island rocket rips through. Or going down to the quarry pool, diving deep into those cold black wells. Nobody tries to stop her because there's nobody there to tell her to be careful.
That's it, Alma. We start without her.
Just 5 more minutes, Josiah. I'm sure she'll be alone.
I've got to be there for the memorial service by 6:55.
I'm sure she'll be alone.
Finally, girl, I was getting worried.
Oh, good, supper's ready. I'm starved.
Sorry about the package. Got a little bit ripped up on the barbary wire up to the quarry.
A little?
Do you have any idea what time it is?
Uh-uh.
It's 6:08.
So?
Dinner in this house starts exactly at 6 o'clock.
And Jackie's dinner was whenever you got to the grove.
Would you like to change for supper, girl?
Change what?
Oh, never mind. You can wash up in the kitchen.
I don't need to. I've been swimming over to the quarry.
But the quarry's closed.
And there's a big sign saying no trespassing.
I wasn't trespassing. I was swimming.
Remember the memorial service, Alma? They can't get started without the ashes.
That's disgusting.
It's a business.
That's disgusting.
What are we supposed to do? Let people decompose wherever they drop dead?
That's disgusting.
I don't see how you can do that.
Do what?
Touch food with hands that have touched the dead.
I use a fork.
Shall we say a blessing?
Bless us, O Lord, for these thy gifts, which we are about to receive through thy mercy.
Now?
Now. I heard a queer thing from Izzy today. Folks are having trouble with the milking. Cows have gone dry morning and evening.
What? I heard...
Don't talk with your mouth full.
Once I heard how a woman can milk a cow a mile away by bringing water out of a clean white dish rag.
There is entirely too much. There is entirely too much witch talk in this town.
Have you ever seen Mother Hicks? People say she comes to the graveyard at night and does spells.
I don't want you going to the graveyard, girl. Not at night.
Not at any time. You kids are always knocking over the gravestones and tearing up the plots. If I catch you in that graveyard, you're going to wish I hadn't.
Can I give you another biscuit, girl?
No.
What?
No biscuit, I'm not hungry.
I was going to wait until after supper, but you might as well have this now.
That package was for me? Since you've been so careless with this, I've half a mind not to give it to you. This is new, ain't it?
Yes.
I can tell because it don't smell like nobody else yet. I never had a new one, not of my own.
You'll need a new dress before you start the big school next fall.
I ain't got no use for school. I'm going to Cairo to sell costume jewelry at Woolworth's.
Oh?
He'll do no such thing. And speaking of school, we'll have to do something about your name.
Well, what about my name?
If you're going to the big school, you'll have to have a proper name.
Why are you always trying to change me?
I'm not trying to change you.
I like my old things better.
Pick it up.
I just want you to be comfortable here.
How can I be comfortable with you always picking and pecking at me? I feel like a bird feeder.
Young lady, that is enough.
It's all right, Josiah.
It's not all right. She comes in here like a tornado and acts like a hooligan when you're just trying to give her something nice.
I don't want anything. I don't want anything from you.
Go to your room.
It's not my room. And I'm going out. There's something I've got to do.
The only thing you're going to do is get to your room before I let a spanking teach you some manners. Do you understand? I told you this.
It might if you weren't so hard on her.
Hard on her?
It won't work. We just have to be patient.
We're just too old to be starting again with children. And that one will tear you up. Alma, that kid was born bad, and there's nothing you can do to break her of it.
I can try.
I give it another week, but then she goes.
There's nowhere else for her to go.
There's the state home.
Not while I have breath.
The state home is where that child belongs.
Not while I have breath.
Oh, to sleep, you little babe.
Go to sleep, you
as she runs down the darkening streets until she can't run anymore, or climbs a huge pecan tree to try to touch a star. I am there alone in shadow, never seen, but never far. Should she fall or suddenly be frightened, out late, deep in the night, she goes to the graveyard in the pale moonlight.
Oh my heavens, I'm standing on one. Sorry. There's no such thing as spooks. There's no such thing as spooks.
Go to sleep, you little baby. Go to sleep, you little baby.
My heart is pounding louder than thunder, louder than Jesus. I close my eyes and see her eyes shooting sparks. A witch can kill with a look, but then I see it like a match flare up inside her eyes, like she recognized me, like she knew me forever. But then her eyes go deep as wells and fill up with a kind of sadness. She recognized me and I recognized her too. She looked at me and she knew me all my life. ISH. H for Hicks.
I thought I told you to stay out of the graveyard.
Oh!
Girl, I warned you.
Witches is never lonely or afraid because they got the power.
Early one morning, just before dawn,
I hitch up my cart and come down the long road.
Down to the town from the hill where I stay.
I don't usually see much, but on this one day, I come to a clearing near a stream and a tree, and I saw the strangest thing I ever did see.
This is how you get to be a witch. Every morning, just before dawn, from Sabbath to Sabbath, go to a clear, cold stream where the water runs east. Take a new white porcelain pan and an old knife gone red with rust. Wash that knife in the water and pour a full pan of cold, clear water over your head, saying, I swear that I do give everything betwixt my two hands to the ways of witchcraft. And I swear to do anything he asks of me.
The very next day I followed the girl as she wandered around. Strange things started happening all over town.
Day one. Mother.
make a witch ball. Gather up some cow hair licked with cow spit, mixed with salt and tallow. Gather ashes from a burned down church, get some moss from a tombstone, and roll it all in a ball around a little piece of razor.
Oh my garters! Oh my garters!
What in the world's the matter?
Look there! What do you see?
Why, Izzy, it looks like you're supper for the Sunday church social.
No, look there on top of the pecan pie. Look on top of the pie.
Ew, it looks like a bug. A big hairy bug?
It's a ball. A witch ball.
Day two, Tuesday.
A spell can be done by placing a witch wreath inside a person's hat for hex. The spell will grow around his head and he is sure to go mad.
It's a what?
A witch wreath made with feathers from a black hen.
And you pulled that thing out of my hat?
I think your headaches will stop now, Hosea.
So you mean to tell me that a bunch of feathers caused my headaches?
Nope, made your hat fit too tight.
Day three, Wednesday.
A witch can turn herself into a black panther cat and prowl around unnoticed. That cat steals something from someone, she will have power over them for sure.
I tell you, it was a cat. A big black panther cat. An unnaturally large panther cat. And I heard it prowling around my wash line and it stole a pair of my parcels.
Now let me get this straight. A cat steals your drawers and ever since, your vision's blurred, there's a ringing in your ear, you got the chills, the faints, the shakes, and the gas.
That's my clothes.
And doggone says there's nothing wrong with you.
That's how I know I'm doomed. When the doctor can't find the thing wrong, it's a sign that a person's been hexed. She's up to her old tricks.
Mother Hicks.
Mother Hicks.
Day four, Thursday.
I swear that I do give everything betwixt my two hands.
When I woke the girl this morning, she was burning up with fever. Her hair was wet and she was all cold and clammy.
What does Doc Gunner say?
He's afraid it's pneumonia.
Put a silver bullet in a bog and tie it around her neck.
Whatever for?
To protect her from witches.
Doc Gunner says it's pneumonia.
Day five, Friday.
It just has to be Mother Hicks, Clovis. We've all been witched by Mother Hicks.
It's just like it was in 1925.
But in 1925, they all died.
Day six, Saturday.
Girl is going to the hospital, and she is going today.
But Doc Gunner says she's better off at home.
She's delirious. This morning she woke up screaming something about witchcraft.
Day seven, the second Sabbath.
I swear that I do give everything.
It's a witch ball.
Everything.
I got these headaches.
Everything.
It's pneumonia.
Everything.
They all die.
Everything.
Mother Hicks.
Twix.
Mother Hicks.
My two hands.
Mother Hicks.
To the waist.
Mother Hicks. Mother Hicks. Mother Hicks. Mother Hicks. Mother Hicks. Mother Hicks.
Take the red rust knife and cut the head off a living thing with the blood falling. But I don't want to be that kind of witch, the kind that kills things. A flower's a living thing. I swear that I do give everything betwixt my two hands to the ways of... Oh, I cut myself bad! I cut myself bad! Oh! Oh! Oh.
Thank you.
who you are. You'll
drink.
No!
Drink or you're strangled on your own phlegm.
What is that?
Bruce, scaly bark, pokeweed, and rattlesnake yarn.
It tastes terrible.
Better than dying.
This ain't my shirt. It smells foul.
Grease it goes with hog fat and nutmeg.
Why?
Reasons.
What are you doing with that?
Hold her.
No! Let me go!
Hold still.
No! What's that?
Hot yellow and vinegar to help draw the poison.
Ow!
Hush up, you ain't hurt. You ain't hurt, are you?
Some.
If I can't stop the festering, I'll have to cut it off.
The mud?
The leg.
No!
Hold still and let this poultice dry. I'll have to tie you down if you don't. We'll leave her out here while the weather holds. Inside smells like skunk.
What are you going to do with me?
Girl, I'm doing with you now. Sister Kicker Hesh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 alive and come this dead one, stuck. There ain't no help for it, Sister Kicker. There ain't no help.
What are you doing?
Stay away.
What's happening?
I said stay away.
Keep the light over here, Tuck.
Well, stop it, please. Whatever you're doing, stop.
I can't. There, got it. Now let them come. Snip, snip, and flip them off. Flip them clean.
There's blood.
There's always blood at a birthing.
A rabbit?
Rabbits.
I never heard a rabbit make such a noise before.
They only do when they're hurt or more scared.
How many babies?
5 alive, 3 dead.
Yeah, can I see?
If she gets riled, she'll eat them.
Well, why would she eat her own baby?
Who knows why some critters don't take their young? No reason, they just don't.
But will she ever?
Likely not. It's like the sky's about to make itself a dawn. Come here. I said, come here. Fever's broke. Better get back to bed before it's light.
Well, can I name the rabbits?
No, but you can help. Now there you are, all fresh and clean, to go visiting. Tonight we'll go just like I promised. Tonight we'll go. Now none of that splashing, you hear? And no spitting either. Now stop. I say stop if you can't keep from dousing. What are you peeping at?
Nothing.
You call me nothing?
I didn't see nothing.
And if lies was food, there'd be no hunger in the world.
I know what you're doing.
What?
You're milking a cow by magic.
This here's laundry. I save the soapy water for my yards.
Oh, well, if it's laundry, I can help. I can use these flannel pieces and use them to wring the water out. Oh, this is baby clothes.
It is.
There used to be all kinds of babies.
is over at Jackie's. Jackie's is where I used to stay, and I used to love to play with them. They was all soft and white and plumped up, like dough before it's baked. Soft little bread babies.
This shirt is fine linen. I can see right through it.
You be careful, mind.
I'm mine.
Once there was a girl who wore that dress, and she had hair-colored hair. Well, you know how some folks go on about their kids and say they have hair blonde as gold or eyes blue as sky? Well, this little girl, she had hair-colored hair and eye-colored eyes, and she were beautiful.
What happened to that girl?
Gone. Taken with the rest.
Gone? Gone where?
Just gone.
Well, taken by who?
Watch how you touch that piece. You're strangling the life out of it.
But I want to know.
Well, wanting ain't getting. What in the? Well, I don't know what.
What are you two laughing at?
This here fool.
Jackie always told me it were nice to laugh at him just because he's afflicted.
He told me a riddle.
What?
He just make it up. What looks just like half a chicken?
I don't know what.
The other half.
He told you that?
He did.
How?
With them air pictures.
You mean all that figuring around means things?
They teach him that over at the state school, where he learned to lip talk. Then after he left and his people died, he came around here and he just stayed. I teach him some I made up, and he teach me some he learned, and we just built ourselves a talking way.
Oh. Is he talking to me?
It appears that way, but you're too ignorant to understand.
I am not ignorant.
In his talk, you are. He says, you are my friend.
Oh.
What's he saying now?
Well, he says, you look at me and can only see the things I cannot do, things I cannot be. That I can taste the cool spring water and know what month it is. I can smell the difference between the smoke of hickory and applewood. I can see the sharp sting of honey and taste the sunrise.
Don't he mean he can taste the honey and see the sunrise?
He means what he says, and that's the trouble with you town folk. You see and you hear, but you don't know nothing.
Well, down in town, nobody knows he stays up here.
I don't much care what they know of town.
What's he saying?
He's asking if you can put your old shirt on. You smell like a buzzard egg gone bad.
I do.
Fever's broke, so I suppose it's all right. It's in the cabin. Go ahead and get it. No talk. As soon as she's well, she'll go. She's just here for a spell. All critters come for the healing, and when they're done, they go. I know talk. You stay.
There's a whole zoo in there.
Well, just the geese, the squirrels, and a family of skunks.
Skunks? What's he saying?
I already told you that. You got the memory of an ant.
Oh, you are my friend.
Now, I can't sit around here jaw-jacking with you two. I've got work to do.
Are you going to do secret things?
I'm going to hang up this here laundry. So that's in your business.
I just wonder.
If you want to make yourself some use, you can feed them rabbits and see if you can find their name.
But I want to name them myself.
Every critter's got a name inside him. You can't just make it up. But sometimes, if you watch him close enough, you can find it.
I don't understand.
It don't matter. The rabbits do.
Sure is ugly, ain't it?
Looks like a rat.
Wouldn't it be something if you could remember when you was as young as they is? If you could remember lying there and all of a sudden you see this big old milk nipple coming towards you and wham, supper. Sometimes I can remember that far back. I really can. I can just barely see hair-colored hair and eye-colored eyes. Do you remember your people, Tuck? Your pa and your mama? They're dead, ain't they? You're lucky. Not on account of them being dead, that part's sad, but you're lucky you know where they are. You can close your eyes and you can see them living inside of your mind.
when you don't know about them, there's always something inside you that's hungry. When I see you staring at me, your eyes all big and round, I feel like I could fall right inside both your eyes and be lost forever. Oh, don't look at me, I'm just talking loom talk. Loom talk, that's me. Could you teach me things? Teach me secret things?
Don't know any secret things.
Well, you know, some people call this place Witch Mountain.
Some people are stupid.
I want to show you something. Something special. Have you ever seen this piece before?
Yep.
You have?
When you first came, I practically had it pried out of your hands.
I mean before. Have you seen this before that?
I don't know. Maybe. Maybe not.
Well, you see, these initials here, they're sewn on by somebody's own hand. And they stand for my name. And what do you think the H would stand for?
I already told you. I don't know. Now cut out the jaw jack and then feed these babies. All this jabbering's getting them right.
You could teach me things.
I wish someone would teach you how to feed a rabbit. You're squirting it up its nose. I swear, out of all the critters I got here, you make the most noise and the least sense. Now I'm going to water my yards, and I want you to watch her. Stay put.
Is she always so mean? Oh, is she always so mean? I don't understand. Oh, Mother Hicks. Dirt, ground, world, earth. Mother Hicks, earth, and wind, blow all over air. And fire and water and cut blood and tears. Mother Hicks is earth and air and fire and water and blood and tears. Mother Hicks is everything.
And then they'd make me bring her back again.
That morning before I left, I stood and watched her sleep.
I pressed my thoughts and feelings deep inside my memory.
And where in the blazes have you been? Take a little vacation, did you? The whole town's been going downhill. My stock boy decided to give himself a vacation.
Morning, Clovis, in the news?
I went to the highway patrol station on my way in this morning. They haven't seen her, but they suggested you call the state home. They keep runaways there sometimes, and I'll call if you like.
Well, thank you, Clovis. I'm grateful for your help.
I've got a waste with a stockpile of get with it, boy!
So where's Hosea off to in such a hurry?
He's going to Cairo. He figures that's where girl looking for the Hammonds.
The whole time she was with them, they let her run wild. Let all them kids run wild. Just wild things. Now I'm sure that's where she went.
She had pneumonia. She wouldn't have made it as far as the county line. Did you find her?
Who's Aaron? I've been to the Cairo Employment Office, the Welfare Department, and called every Hammond in the entire city. Not one of them has ever heard of Jackie or the girl. Alma, we've tried.
Not hard enough.
There's nothing more we can do.
When our boy was born dead, there was nothing we could do. When the scarlet fever took Sarah, there was nothing we could do. But this time,
Hosea, this time there is something we can do. We can keep looking!
think you're going? Don't you go waggling your fingers at me. Got yourself a new habit, boy? Help yourself, did you? What's the matter with you, boy? What's the matter with you, anyway?
Home late, long into night. A winding up trail in pale moonlight. The feeling deep inside makes me want to run and hide. So I turn, nothing. And I turn, no one. Then I turn and I see there ain't no one there but me. But I run, anyway.
That won't take too kindly to an intruder just because you've got the willies.
What's wrong?
Nothing. He's just got the jumps. Now go and eat. You got black beans.
Hey, thanks. You was over in town today? Did you hear anything? You know anything about me? Nothing? My whole life I lived in that town, and now they don't even notice once I'm gone.
Down in town is a mighty measly place.
But it's different here.
Here my walls is made of tar paper, so creatures can come and go as they please. There ain't no keeping out, and there ain't no holding in.
Why do the animals come here?
They come for the healing. When there's a festival lamps or something broken to be bound up or cut away. They come when they can't do for themselves.
Well, and after, what happens after they's all right?
Well, Tuck and me, we walk them close to see if we can find their names. Then they can go and we'll always know them again. Go and get that bedding so this little chicken can roost. I don't want you chewing.
Well, what if an animal doesn't want to go?
Sooner or later they do. They all do.
Will you wrap me up tight in them blankets like when I first came?
Why?
Because I kind of feel like I'm a little tiny worm all wrapped up in a cocoon.
Well, I ain't going to be expecting no butterflies at breakfast time. And what are you doing with that? Guarding against what?
Something's wrong, isn't it?
Sleep tight, little rabbit, and don't you worry about nothing. Lesson it's Daniel Boone over there shooting off his own foot.
I thought I heard something.
What?
I thought I heard something. Over there.
Who's there? I said, who's there?
So it is you, and you've got...
Tuck! Tuck, you fool, it ain't no use!
Witch stories or to trespassing.
We're talking about kidnapping.
We are talking about witchcraft, Clovis.
And when she told Ozai and me, you can sit around here jawjacking, but I'm going up that hill.
Tonight? She's going up there tonight.
And don't you dare try to stop me, Ozai Ward.
And then she asked me to lead her the way, and when I hesitated, she said,
Clovis, I do believe you're scared.
It just makes sense to be scared when you're dealing with a witch.
Dealing with a shotgun.
If you won't go with me, I swear I'll go.
So I told her I'd go.
Clovis, P.U., if you think I'm going to racing up Witch Mountain in my condition,
then
you
behind.
And miss everything.
You don't want her to come back, do you?
Oh, Alma.
Do you?
I just don't want her to hurt you again.
I'll be all right, and I have to know that she's all right.
I'll get my climbing boots.
Better bring mine, too. And, Josiah, you better bring your gun.
Slow down. I can't follow you. no right. They've got guns. Fools.
What's happened?
Tuck says some folks from town is on their way up here. He says they're riled and they got guns.
But why?
Something to do with you.
Let's witch them. All of them. Let's you and I witch them all.
What did you say?
Let's throw them a spell to turn the road to slime and let them slide all the way back down Main Street.
Stop that jabbering.
You can do it, and I can help. I know who I am.
You don't know nothing.
Yes, I do. I swear that I do give everything betwixt my two hands to the ways of witchcraft.
Stop that!
Why? I know that you're a witch.
I'll tell you, witches. I'll tell you witchcraft. When the fever comes and makes the babies scream and burn up in their beds and die, it has to be a spell. When a child's born all crippled up or deaf or blind, it can't be because its mother took no notice to the measles. It's a hex. When the hand of God strikes a good man down or takes away his job, it has to be someone's fault. It has to be witchcraft.
But Mother Hicks.
Don't you ever call me that.
Why not?
Don't you ever say that to me again.
I know that I'm your child.
My child was taken.
They say you gave her to the devil.
I never gave her up. I held her all the time she screamed. I held her all the time she cried. I held her when she died of the fever.
She died?
And then, after, I held her in my own two arms and I laid her in the ground all by myself.
But my quill piece, you know you've seen this piece before. And the H, it stands for Hicks.
Home. It stands for home. Illinois State Home.
What?
I've seen this piece before. I wrapped you in it just after you were born. Your mother came here from the state home. Scared and all alone, barely more than a child herself, I helped her with the birthing.
That's not true.
And then, one day she ran and she took you with her. She must have left you in town on her way to somewhere else.
And so I am...
the orphan child of an orphan child.
That's not true.
Yes, it is, little rabbit.
No, it isn't. Witches is never lonely or afraid because they got the power. I'm your child and you are a witch.
I'm not a witch.
Then what are you?
I'm just a leftover person, just like you.
That's not true.
I threw away the shells. I was afraid someone would get hurt. Now they're coming for you and you'll go back to town with them because that's where you belong.
No, it isn't.
Let her go, Tuck. One more step and you're on private property.
Beg your pardon, Miss Hicks.
You've got exactly 3 seconds to get your backsides down this hill.
We don't want any trouble. Please, the girl's been missing over a week.
That ain't no concern of mine.
We just want to look around.
You got a warrant?
Please, I need to see for myself.
Don't look at her, Alma. She'll witch you. You never change, do you? What have I ever done you except give you a place to put your hate?
You know what you did. Name the Father.
Stop that!
Can't say any other word of God.
Prayers used that way is blasphemy.
You'll cry blasphemy over witching our children.
I never hurt a child.
But they died. You touch those babies and they died.
It was the fever.
Stand aside or use that gun. We're coming in.
What gives you the right? What gives any of you the right to talk and talk and talk and call me a witch?
She just wants the girl.
She ain't here.
Please let me look. I care for her. We just want the girl.
The use. You'll take whatever you want, come in here with guns, and call me criminal.
We just want the girl.
Then what? But just one. I won't have you all trampling through my house. I'm not the one with the gun.
Who then?
The child.
Mama! Lord, no! No child of mine!
Izzy, please! She can't hurt you, Ricky. Do it for the girl, Ricky. Dare and double dare.
Hi, Ricky. If you're from this girl, you better tell her I did this.
Smell like
smoke.
She ain't in there. There's nothing in there but
animals. That's right. You want a witch? Then witch I'll be. When you look, you see what you want to see.
It's a spell.
You better get off my property before I lock your jaw and turn your blood to poison.
We don't want any trouble.
Then get off my property. And you better have a silver bullet in that gun.
Who's I?
You got exactly 5 seconds to get your backsides down this hill, or I'll spell y'all to Sunday. One.
Come on, boys.
Two.
We don't want any trouble.
Three.
Come on, all right.
Four. Five.
She was ill. She had pneumonia.
Not anymore.
She was here. When did she leave?
Not long ago.
Where'd she go?
I don't know.
If she comes back, if you see her, please, please tell her I want her to come back.
I'll go.
She ain't here and she ain't there. This time, the girl has disappeared.
I know, because I've looked everywhere, and I'm used to shadows, but she ain't there. Or anywhere.
Excuse me,
yeah?
Sir.
Yeah? What do you want, kid?
Never mind, sorry.
Places. Well,
Now, Ella and Beck and the baby, well, they're with my sisters. And then Margaret, she went to go work in Down City. Libby's with my aunt in Memphis. And then Sarah? God, where is Sarah? You don't remember?
I remember a second. How and where is Sarah?
St. Louis.
That's right. She went to go live with that one family, take care of their baby. Sarah's always good with babies, you remember.
Well, Sarah weren't no older than me.
Anyway, they seem like nice folks.
I got 10 bottles today. That's good, isn't it, Mom?
Well, anyway, me and Howie here, we've just been camping out until something better comes along, eh, Howie?
10 bottles is good, isn't it?
What about your job?
It wasn't a job.
Last night I only got 6.
What about WPA?
Now, I would take a handout.
I heard that already.
There wasn't any money for food.
But there was money for that.
Hey, now don't you judge me. You ain't got the rap.
You just had a family, but you just threw it away.
Don't you talk to my mom like that.
You threw it all away.
I just couldn't hold on to them.
Get out of here.
You could have held on to them.
Where are you going?
What do you care?
We're doing okay, Mom. Yeah, Howie, we're doing okay.
There you are. Don't you look something all dressed up to Sunday? Mind you don't get this pretty little dress dirty. I just washed it. The rabbits is doing fine, and we got ourselves a whole family of raccoons. The raccoons got into rat poison, I reckon, but they're doing fine on sour milk and apple pies. I wish you could see them.
I was afraid you wouldn't be here.
I didn't come here looking for you out of reasons.
I know. I'm sorry for what I said to you. I just needed it to be true. Please, look at me. She's there, isn't she? What was her name?
Mary.
Mary.
It ain't Mary, and it ain't Marie. It's Mary.
Mary. I'm sorry I ran away.
Hers always going is healed.
But I'm not healed. Not yet. But I do know one thing. I know one thing for positive sure. Someday things are going to belong to me, and I'm going to belong to them. But I won't be healed until I find something.
You'll never find it. No matter how hard you look, you'll never find that poor, scared rabbit that gave you birth.
I know that part of me isn't hungry anymore. It's just sad.
That woman, almost she cares.
I know, but I can't go back until I find what I mean.
What?
A name. I need a name. So I wonder, could I have her name? Could I be Mary?
It's her name. It ain't yours.
But I wish it were.
Well, you can wish in one hand, spit in the other, and see which one gets full first.
Could you help me find my name?
I reckon I could.
so I can stay with you just for a while?
There's comfort, healing, spell, and when they're done, they go.
I know.
We shall not, we shall not be there. We shall not, we shall not be just like a tree standing by the water. We shall not be there.
Mother Hicks is a witch, people say, and she lives all alone at the top of Dug Hill, and she works her magic on the town below.
When a child falls sick, and there ain't no cause,
and there ain't no cure,
then everybody knows there's witch for sure.
Mother Hicks is a witch, people say.